it is a force which requires discipline, and I consider myself fit for this job.
Okay, like on going through your day, I have seen that you have tried for this serious jump also.
Yes.
You appeared for, must have appeared for interview in serious examination.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And in 2015 you appeared for it, then again in 2016 you appeared, and then again in 2017 you appeared. Okay. So like, what were the reasons, like why you didn't qualify in this CDS exam?
Yes, sir.
Why you didn't qualify in this exam? Like how you are assessed, like where you are lacking?
In the first attempt, I hadn't prepared for the CDS exam because I'm doing job, and that's why in the first two attempts. And the third attempt, I cleared the exam and I got screened out in the very first attempt.
Okay.
And this time I have cleared once again, but the interview dates are out here.
In the first two attempts, you didn't prepare well.
Yes.
Because you were working somewhere.
Yes.
Where you were working?
So, I'm working on a stack firm under my engineering. I haven't got placement, but I want to see my field. What I have learned in my 4 years, I want to have a hands-on experience on that. It's a field job, so I want to have experience on that. So I worked in Barmer in Rajasthan, in Oilfield, and in Rajasthan work, in Durgapur.
In which company you are working in Rajasthan and in Durgapur?
In Durgapur, I have worked in Akash Exploration, and in Barmer I have worked in BHS, Barmer Services. I haven't got any placement offer like that, but I contacted my seniors, they give me that opportunity, and I worked.
So like when you were working and when you knew this fact that you were not well prepared, so why you appeared for the second?
Because from my 10th, you can say that I want to join forces because my father is in Air Force. So I want to join this. So that's why I'm giving my IDF the CDS attempt. But after working for 1 year, I start preparing for the competitive exams. And then I do my best and clear the exam.
Don't you think that you are giving contradictory statement? On the one side, you are saying that after your 12th, you are very much ambitious about joining defense forces.
Yes.
And then you said that you got a job in this oil field, and that's why you prepared for your CDS exam.
Yes, sir.
Don't you think that you are giving contradictory statement? On the one side, you are saying that you had a dream to join the forces.
Yeah, I after my 12th, I applied for the CDS and applied for the NDA and technical entry schemes. I appeared for the SSV, but didn't clear that time. And then I joined graduation in petroleum engineering. So after that, I see that okay, I have taken a step, and I start preparing for my. Because my 4 year of my life is going to decide my whole career. So I preparing for my engineering very well. And after 4 years of engineering, I want to pursue my career as an engineer. So that's why I work for 1 year. And after that, the contract is over. The company in which I am working, the contract is over. So they are not able to accommodate us. I took it as a sign because I want to join forces, so let's prepare for it.
What were the reasons why the company didn't accommodate you in there?
Sir, because in petroleum, I have done my engineering in petroleum engineering. It is basically related to upstream work, because extraction of crude oil from the subsurface to the surface, and then transported it to the that comes in midstream. So because there is a oil crisis in 2015, because the current oil market prices drastically from $110 per barrel to $30 per barrel. So in India, the work really stops because the big players are finding very hard. The small companies started to close down. And in India, the exploration work totally stops. So that's why after 1 year, the contract got over. So the company shut down their operations because the ONGC, Cain India, they are big players. They are not exploring any other field because they are finding it very, because the extraction cost is more and the import is quite import is quite cheaper than the exploration in our country, because the recovery in the field is secondary recovery. The oil is not coming to the surface on its own. They have to inject chemicals, so the operating cost is more in India. So they stop the operations, and India is importing crude from Middle East countries, which is quite cheaper. Right,
can you name 5 top petroleum companies with their CEOs who are working in India right now?
5 big petroleum companies which are working in India. Government or private? If you see government, in government we have ONGC and Oil India, which is exploring in northeast areas. In private we have got Cane India, which is exploring the Rajasthan Barmer field, and Oil India. And the service providers are there: Halliburton, it is a USA company; Schlumberger, it is a service provider company, not the operator. And many Akash Exploration are there. SR is exploring in West Bengal, Durgapur. They are exploring gas, coal and methane. And there are these are the main players. Small companies are there, but they are providing services in the particular specific field.
And you have stated your father is working in Air Force. What is his rank?
Sir, he is non-commissioned, he is airman, joined as an airman, as a soldier.
What is his rank?
He is JW.
JW stand for?
A Julian Warrant Officer.
What is his trade?
Yes, sir.
What is his trade?
Trade is weapon fitter, sir.
Weapon fitter. Okay. Who is the chief of the Air Staff?
Air Marshal Dhanoa, sir.
Air Marshal Dhanoa. How many field of Air Marshal Indian Air Force has till date?
How many fields?
Field Marshal of Air Force Indian Air Force has till date?
So that I don't know.
You are staying in Air Force areas till date?
No, yes, sir.
Your father is still in service?
Yes, he's in service.
Where is he posted?
He's posted in Bangalore.
Bangalore? It is Jalari East or West?
West.
West unit?
If it is, I haven't visited my father in Bangalore because I am working and preparing.
You are not writing letter to him?
No.
Have you posted any letter to him?
No, sir.
No. You have not visited him?
No, sir.
No. It means you have not seen the Bangalore?
No, sir, I haven't.
You have seen Pune?
Yes, sir, I have seen Pune.
Where you are posted?
It is in Lohegaon, Air Force Station Lohegaon.
Lohegaon. It is 2-wing Air Force?
A 2-wing Air Force.
Okay. That Air Force area in Pune?
Yes, sir.
It is near to one prison. What is his name?
Yerwada.
Yerwada. What are the other places which we can visit in Pune if we go?
You can go to Lonavala. Lavasa city is there. And the Pune is quite good because all the fountains are there nearby. You can go and visit and have a good time with friends.
Do you think that Lonavala is in Pune?
So it is 15 kilometers from 30 kilometers.
My question was very straight.
Singer Fort.
If we want to visit Pune, what are the places we can see?
Singhad Fort, you can see. Singhad Fort is a quite historical place, and in Simhapada there is a temple. It is quite famous for Ganpati ji.
How many years were there in Pune?
Four years.
4 years? You have studied there?
Yes, sir.
Your father is a non-commissioned officer. Okay. What are the rank structure up to Master Warrant Officer? Listen carefully. I want rank structure only up to the rank of Master Warrant Officer, not further.
rank structure in non-commissioned force in Air Force?
Yeah, non-commissioned. For an airman? Okay.
Sir.
One commissioned rank in the Air Force has been demolished. Now it is no more existing. What is that rank?
Rank in Air Force, in commissioned officer.
Yeah. That is in all three defense forces, one rank has been abolished. It is no more exist. What is that rank? You have tried for CDS, you have appeared in SSV.
No, sir.
Okay, how many other places you have seen in Air Force other than Pune and Bangalore?
Air Force Station Amla, that is in MP, Bethul, near Bethul.
Okay.
I didn't met 10th from there. And before that, my father is in Gurgaon for 5 years. That is my hometown. Before Amla, I have seen Gurgaon, Grishman, that is my hometown also. And before that, I was quite small. My father is in Guwahati. I visited Guwahati. And Shillong is there.
You have studied in Kendri Vidyalaya?
Yes, sir, Kendri
Vidyalaya. Okay. There is, I think, English medium?
English medium.
What is question type?
What is?
Question type.
Question.
English है ना, English पढ़ी है ना?
Yes, sir.
Question type क्या होता है?
Question.
मुझसे मेरा बच्चा पूछ रहा था आते समय, वो अंग्रेजी का कुछ पढ़ रहा था, तो डैडी question type क्या है, तो मैं सोचा चलो आज पूछ लेता हूँ आपसे.
Question type. Ask a question.
Okay, if I ask you what is your name, is it a question type?
Because if there is a choice, I want to be with my family. I will rank in that case, and my family relative, my father told me to put it as a choice one. Otherwise, for me, service is important. It is just a preference. Something has to be first, and something has to be last.
Okay. So, Pratik, as sir has asked many questions about your father's profession, you didn't answer properly. It means you are not having any bond or any communication with your father and you. This is so sad.
No, I am quite frank with my father. He talked to me like a friend, not as a father. But the thing is that I never discussed about his professional life. And this is the case.
Okay, so you have participated in chess.
Yes,
sir. At which level you have participated? In college?
At my school level.
At your school level.
Yeah.
Name the three personalities in chess.
Karl Marxen, he is from Russia. He is right now number one in chess. He beat Vishwanath Anand. And in India, Vishwanath Anand is there. And we have got Grandmaster, Grandmaster Chopra this year. Mr. Chopra is in 2017.
Minimum kitne moves mein aap apne opponent ko hara sakte ho?
From the start or from if it, when we start the chess that time? Exact answer.
Quite much related to CAPF,
I think, because petroleum engineering is something, a field job. And I have personally done 1 year of work in, on the field. It is like 12, if the shift is of 12 hours, you have to stand on your feet for 12 hours and watch the operation very carefully. And what I have learned in my field job is that in petroleum engineering, the safety is quite important. We are doing our job, that is the secondary thing, but the first thing is safety. If you are on the field, helmet is on. And that kind of discipline is required, because otherwise it will be disastrous for you and for all your crew. And such kind of discipline is required in CAPF. And all the petroleum fields are in remotely located areas, starting from Kemer Basin, Rajasthan, Badmer area is quite remotely located. In northeastern side, in Assam, there are fields, in KG Basin, all these are remotely located areas. And the CAPF job is also related to guarding and protecting the people in that area. So from there, I can relate that CAPF and my engineering is quite related. And in specifically in CISF, we have to guard pipelines. We have to guard pipelines that is carrying crude oil. And petroleum exploration fields, we have to some guards. And at that time, in petroleum engineering will come and help me.
Don't you think ki agar aap private job mein gaye hote to jyada better kar pate? Aapko petroleum field ki knowledge achhi hai, aap wahan pe bhi apna positive de pate. Why do you choose this job, CAPF? It's quite difficult, right? You have to be in isolated places. You have to be apart from your family, and there is no one like, matlab your colleagues and all. Isn't it quite difficult?
Nothing is quite easy. But the thing is that in petroleum engineering, I have to stay away from my family. The same thing is there in CAPF. So I have decided to choose a career like that. So CAPF is not a different thing from my engineering thing, because I will not leave my family in my engineering if I am doing my job. And my father, he is from the last 28 years away from his mother and father. So they are not objecting anything. They are happy because my father is happy. So my family is not going to object like, you are white, why are you not coming home? This is not a big thing. And
tell me one thing. Agar aapki koi subordinate wo continuously leave le rahi hai, to how will you tackle? Seize a lady. She can accuse you also.
I will talk to her, because communication is required to solve such kind of problems. If what made her taking leave often, I will talk to her, and that way I will take her.
She has presented false reasons, which you clearly see. Yeah.
She deliberately want to be on leave. I have to be there in her place, because she is not there, I am working.
But then that will set a negative precedence,
no? No, sir, I am asking, if she was not there, I have to be in that place, I am asking.
She is your subordinate, I have mentioned.
Okay, she is your subordinate. So, she is giving a false reason, all the way. So, I will take her action, because you have to be there, you. I will ask my senior though, if she is not, she is bluffing and she is not coming on the work, that is wrong, because female for workforce is required in the field.
Why should you be selected in assistant commander? Even in three regions, what are that individual traits in you that the UPSC should see, or that differentiate you with other candidates?
From the childhood, I am an outdoor person, and I want to play, because if I have time, I will play. I am not the best, I am an average student at playing, but I have got appreciation from my sports teacher all the time, because of my haircut. It is
because of
my haircut. So he had appreciated me for that reason, because I have a very decent haircut. That made me think that it is a good thing to have a discipline in life.
You should be like selected for your haircut.
No, no. It is one of the traits which is required. That is discipline.
Discipline comes from haircut.
Yeah, you can say that. If a person is a decent, he is a disciplined person, he will have a good haircut.
So, say, would you meet a criteria? Like, कोई भी आके haircut वैसे अपना ले और discipline लग जाएगा वो.
Yes, sir. In enforces uniform is required. Uniform is required. So if a person wears a uniform, it shows his discipline. If he wear in a proper way, everything is proper. That shows discipline. And I consider haircut is one of that traits which is required. So from my childhood, I have a disciplined life because of my father, because I have seen the defense area. So discipline is foremost rewarded for me. Other two is responsibility is required. If you have given a job, you have to be responsible for it and complete it within the time. No matter whatever be the situation, you have to do your best with whatever possible resources you have. So in my engineering, I come to know that I have that in me. Next is decision making is important. You have to. One, as a assistant commandant, there are situations because life is going to be adventurous and you will get new situation every day. So you have to be good in decision making.
So decision making is important now?
Yes.
You are an assistant commandant?
Yes.
In Punjab border? Like, now you know a building is there and terrorists are there in that building. You are surrounded this building from all sides. Now, you have killed all the terrorists, but then there is a terrorist who is holding a hostage, he is pointing the gun, his gun on that hostage head, and you are only there, like no one is there, only you are there. Now you have the option to shoot that terrorist, or you may allow him to leave.